this is a good point. We are tasting beer on our tour today. We're not drinking beer. The difference is, well, you can figure out the difference. Never feel bad about leaving beer.
We're not chugging.
I mean, you can, I guess, but hard to chug 2 ounces of beer. Yeah. So, in 1996, 5 years after we got started, we brought on a brewmaster who is from Belgium. His name is Peter Boucart. This guy even knows his name. He's the biggest beer geek I've met today. He's Peter Boucart. And Peter designed, developed this beer. It's called Beer de Mars. And it is based on the work of a Belgian architect. Because Peter is kind of an artist, and his medium happens to be like malt and water and hops and grain and spices. So this is beer about a building. And if you ever ask Peter about beer, it's a lot of fun. Because Peter says that beer is all about the time and the place that it's enjoyed. It doesn't matter what the ingredients are. It doesn't matter, blah, blah, blah. He'll say that's all just blah, blah, blah. So let's toast to here and now with Beer de Mars. It's about a building.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Still bonus points if you toast someone you don't know. What's your name?
Jerry
from Missouri asks, what's going on in all these tanks? You hear that sound? It just stopped? Did you hear it? It's kind of a shaky, shaky, rattly sound. There it is. That's grain, malted barley, going into that mill. And the mill cracks it open. And then it goes into the tank right here, which is called the mash tun. And in the mash tun, you add hot water. Because there's sugar inside that malted barley. And you want the sugar to go into solution. Because in case you haven't heard, beer is a drink. It's not like a solid food. Yeah. So, in the mash tun, if you look in there right now, it looks like oatmeal and it's spinning around in a circle, right? Yep. And that's essentially what it is. It's like a big batch of barley meal instead of oatmeal. Except for the guy from Scotland, we don't like chunks in our beer, right? So, we take everything that's in here, it's called mash, and we put it in the louder tun. The louder tun is the biggest one, and it's the next one right over there. And the louder tun is a big strainer, because we want to get all the liquid out of there and get rid of all the spent grain, the husks, the proteins, everything that's solid, we want it out of there. So that's just a big strainer, and that, so then, it strains the liquid out into the next one, which the engineers call the pre-run vessel, but I call the do-nothing tank, because it doesn't do anything. Right. The mash, or the wort, at this point just sits there and waits until the kettle is ready. The kettle is the last one down there, and the kettle is where it gets boiled. 400 kegs of wort get boiled. You add the hops, and if you're going to put other spices into it, you add it at that point, boil it, then you cool it down, and then you send it to Bo. No, Bo works in the brewhouse. And then you send it down to the cellar, and in the cellar, they're going to cool it down, and they're going to ferment it. They're going to add yeast.
Why do they boil it?
What's that?
What does the boiling do?
The boiling sterilizes it.
Uh-huh.
That's why beer is one of the safest drinks in the world. Because at this point it's boiled, kills anything that's in the water. There's nothing alive in our water, don't worry. It also gets rid of volatile aromas and off flavors and aromas that you don't want in the beer.
Huh. And hops is like a flavoring?
Flowers.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, hops are little flowers, and inside the flowers are essential oils.
Huh.
And the oils act as a bittering agent, they add aroma, and they're a preservative.
Hmm.
Yeah. What? Has anybody ever heard of India Pale Ale?
Yeah.
What country did that originate in?
Britain.
In England, yeah. Because they had to get this beer from England all the way to India. And so they put a lot of hops into it. And when you put a lot of hops into it and boil it for a long time, you get a lot of the preservative character for the hops. Right. Because you couldn't just like put it on an airplane and have it there in like 6 hours. You had to sail all the way around the Horn of Africa, blah, blah, blah. It took a long time. And they wanted the beer to be good.
To what extent does it actually preserve it? And to what extent does the bitterness mask off flavors?
Ooh, that's an interesting question.
I heard that some of the European beers, the reason that they have so much hops is to like lengthen the shelf life.
Yeah, it is a preservative.
It masks the changes, the negative changes that happen when it sits on the shelf.
Well, it depends sort of on when you add the hops to the boil. If you add the hops to the boil really early, then you'll get a lot of bitterness. And there's actually a molecular change that happens where the oil sort of bonds with the wort itself. If you add the hops late in the boil, you'll get a lot of hop aroma, but not a lot of hop bitterness. So the longer you boil it, the more bitterness, the more sort of flavor you'll get from them, and the more preservative. The later you add it in the boil, the less of that you get, and the more aroma you get from the beer.
So you add it later with dry hopping?
Dry hopping? Wow, we are on the nerdiest tour. I love this.
Yeah,
this
are.
Is fun. I'm trying to give you a high five.
Sorry.
Dry hopping doesn't happen in the brew house. Dry hopping, has anybody ever heard that term, dry hopping? That happens in the cellar. So you're done with here. You cool it down, you put it in a great big tank, which we're going to see, by the way, and you add the yeast, and the yeast is fermenting the wort. And if you're going to dry hop a beer, you're going to take the hops and put them into a water solution and put them directly into the fermentation vessel itself and just let them sit there until you're ready to pull them out. That's dry hop. That happens in the cellar.
At what generation do you stop when you're pitching the yeast in the grow?
It depends on how effective it's being. Our house yeast strain, I've heard between 3 and 6 generations. Yeah. Or 3 or 6 reuse of the same yeast. Yeah. So when you're done, when the yeast is done working, you pull it out of the tank and then you can reuse it. And we reuse it somewhere, like I said to this guy, between 3 and 6 times.
Where did you get the yeast?
Oh, that's, you know, that's the rub in brewing. I'll tell you everything about all of our beer. We don't say nothing about yeast. Yeah. He was a hitchhiker. We just picked him up, side of the road. Real tiny hitchhiker.